Hi guys, this is Soumya and welcome back to my channel Just So You Me. It's been a minute since I've done this, since I've uploaded a video. It's been due to a lot of reasons, due to a lot of personal and professional reasons. Nevertheless, today I'm here to tell you how to make the most famous dish of Hyderabad, not the biryani. I'm sure there are thousands of videos for Hyderabadi biryani already out there. So basically, this is the most simple way I found to make Haleem. I've looked up a lot of YouTube videos. That is where I got my information from too. And I put in the easiest and the quickest way to make Haleem. In this video, I'll be making chicken Haleem, but you can substitute it with mutton or vegetables or whatever you may like. Vegetables, chicken and mutton are the only three ingredients that go well with Haleem. I'm not sure, you can try the others and let me know in the comments down below. So without further delay, let's get into the video. The first thing I do is I chop onions into fine slices and I deep fry them till they're golden brown, nice and crispy. And listen to the sizzle, guys. This is something I love cooking for. Yeah, I like to fry my onions at the very beginning of the whole process because I like the oil that it leaves behind and I use it for chicken. And this is one trick that I use in all of my cooking. And I'm leaving some onion behind to cook the chicken later on. Now I'm adding like a pinch of salt so that the onions fry quicker, because this is a very, very time-taking process. I've time-lapsed most of it and I've cut most of the footage, but it takes a lot of time and the heat is something that I can't bear. So I add a little salt for it to fry a little faster. Now all we do is wait for this to become golden fried and crispy. You can completely avoid this step and buy store-bought your fried onions or whatever you call that. But I prefer doing this because it's way cheaper and also I think much more tastier. Next I'll be switching over to a pressure cooker, and to that I will add the oil that we used for the onions. Mind you, it's still hot, so please be careful. And because it's hot, I'm not waiting for it to heat too much. And to that, I'm adding 5 to 6 spoons of ginger garlic paste. I let it fry in the oil for about a few seconds to take off all the rawness of the ginger and garlic. And after that, I'll be adding the onions that I left out in the beginning. I'm gonna let it cook for a bit till it becomes pink in color, and after which I will be adding 6 to 7 green chilies. Let that cook for a while and later on add your garam masalas. I've added cinnamon or dalchini, cardamom or elaichi, cloves or long, black cumin or shahi jeera, and peppercorns or kali mirch. The first time I made Haleem, I looked at many different YouTube videos to come up with the most easiest and simplest recipe possible. And this was the second time when I was making Haleem, and I thought that I would remember everything. But as you can see, I have put all my garam masalas at different timings. But it's okay. As far as it goes in the pressure cooker, it's okay. I'm a kind of cook that eyeballs most of all my recipes, and that is what I'm doing even here. So I've added about 4 teaspoons of salt and about 2 tablespoons of red chili powder. Wash and clean your chicken thoroughly and add it to the mixture. Here I've used about 500 grams, and all your other ingredients also depend on the amount of chicken that you use. Like I said, we could have added the turmeric before as well, but I forgot, so I'm adding it now. It's about again 2 teaspoons of turmeric, and also I've added peppercorn. Now I'm adding pure desi ghee. This is really important for Haleem if you want that very rich taste. After that, I'm adding a cup of curd.
What you see here on my screen is a mixture of dalia or broken wheat with a couple of dals and a little rice, and I pressure cooked it for about 4 whistles. This step I usually do while I'm frying onions. So once you pressure cook the dalia, what you do is let it cool and then make it into a fine paste.
Here I forgot to show you the clip where I add mint leaves and coriander leaves which go into the pressure cooker as well. Wait for about 5 to 6 whistles so that the chicken gets really tender and you can pull out any bones that by chance are in your mixture. After that, I am taking the same kadai that we used to fry the onions and frying kaju and badam in desi ghee to garnish the haleem.
Don't worry, you can pour back the desi ghee into the haleem because no amount of ghee is enough for haleem. Okay, so here I've skipped a few steps where I didn't show you when I make the dalia mixture into a paste, nor did I show you where I make the chicken into a paste. All you have to do is wait for the dalia to cool down and then make it into a paste. The same thing you do with the chicken mixture. Make sure that you don't grind the chicken too fine because it will become just like a paste. Mix both of them together and like I showed you on the screen just a few seconds back, wait for the oil, all the ghee and all the oil to just surface on top, and wait for the haleem to become this consistency, and basically you're done. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, do like it, share and subscribe to my channel, and do not forget to click that bell notification to be notified whenever I upload videos. I hope you like this video and show me some love, guys. Bye.